We are on time. Let's start.
So we start?
Yes, yes, you go ahead.
Okay. So good afternoon to all. And today we start one of the very simple and a topic which you, most of you know, and is just kind of a brush up. And we can take up some questions if you have any. On this topic, basically this topic I wanted to highlight as a role of a athlete support personnel in form of a coach in terms of the anti-doping activities. Like, what is the role and what are the responsibilities of a coach, exactly what the coaches are supposed to do if they ever handle any, investigation regarding the anti-doping process. So I'll not take much time and we'll just cover up this topic. So first, मुझे लगता है आप सब लोगों को आर्टिकल 21.2 इन द वाडा कोड, यू ऑल मस्ट बी अवेयर कि उसके प्रोविजंस क्या हैं और एज अ एथलीट सपोर्ट पर्सनल, एज अ कोच, व्हाट यू शुड नो एंड व्हाट यू शुड बी aware of. So I will just go through the article and then we will discuss in detail about it ki uska meaning kya hai. The first point is that you should be knowledgeable about and comply with all the anti-doping policies and the rules as adopted by the World Anti-Doping Agency's code of conduct, which was published in 2015, amended in 2019. And now we are moving to the 2021 code, which is in process and will be updated soon. So this is a ever evolving thing. And it is a document that WADA publishes. And that is like a reference thing for us. So second thing is you all should cooperate with the athlete testing program. As an athlete support personnel, you should always willingly participate and should not obstruct the doping program. So moving to the third point, that is to use his or her influence on athlete values and behavior to foster anti-doping attitude. Matlab aap aisa kuch bhi kaam nahi karenge jiski aapki jo command hai, aapki superiority, aapka jo, being a coach and athlete relationship, you will not exploit that. And you will not do anything that obstructs the anti-doping process or, foster the this thing attitudes. So moving to the fourth point, that is to disclose his or her national anti-doping organization and international federation any decision by non-signatory finding that he or she has committed an anti-doping rule violation with the previous 10 years. Meaning, aap aisa कुछ भी अगर आपके फाइंडिंग में हो कि आपका कोई एथलीट है who has been sanctioned or who has not been sanctioned but has committed some anti-doping rule violation, then आप वो आपके respective federation को बताएंगे, आपके respective anti-doping agency को बताएंगे. I mean, you will not be a mute spectator. That is, this rule means that. So you have to speak up or you have to intimate the agency which is involved. The fifth point is to cooperate with anti-doping organization investigating anti-doping rule violation. ऐसा हो सकता है कि आप एक investigation के part हो सकते हो, as a evidence आप present किए जा सकते हो, as a witness आपके आप पेशी की जा सकती है, and at that time you should be true कि आपको जो पता है वही आपको वहाँ बताना है. You will not conceal anything, any information in such investigations that are happening from time to time by the respective national doping agency. Like in India, it is NADA. Sixth point is athlete support personnel shall not use or possess any prohibited substance or prohibited method without valid justification. Now we'll come to detail about all these things with some examples I will be doing. So, let's consider first thing is tampering or attempted tampering with any part of doping. Basically, I'm discussing part of article 21.2 also and some of the anti-doping rule violation jo aap sabko pata hone chahiye ki aapka role jahan pe fit hota hai, like what as an athlete support personnel, as a coach basically. So that says that any basically what the rule says is any attempt to interfere or tamper with doping control process in any way. सो दिस में इंक्लूड आप सैंपल को डिस्ट्रॉय करोगे या आप सैंपल ठीक से कलेक्ट करने नहीं दोगे या यू नो यू विल हैव अ फ्रॉड इन्फॉर्मेशन यू विल कंसील द इन्फॉर्मेशन मे बी आप जिस का सैंपल लेना है उसको नहीं भेज मे बी देयर विल बी मिसमैच और यू विल यू नो ट्राई टू ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट द एंटी डोपिंग प्रोसेस सो एग्जाम्पल जैसे नीचे दिया है कि अ कोच यू नो बाय हिज you know the stature or you know by his superiority authority he tried to intimidate the doping control officials when they attempted to test one of their athletes because you know in this case the coach might have known that the athlete usne kuch banned substance liya hai or something is there so you know in order to protect that he might use his powers and the coach refused to allow the test to occur and athlete ko ghar bhej diya you know just a way of protecting But that's not the case. If the anti-doping agency comes to know कि आपने ऐसा कुछ किया है, you have obstructed, आपने आपके एथलीट को जानबूझ के घर भेज दिया and you tried to cover up the operation, so you will also be sanctioned for violation of anti-doping rule, and that goes on you as a coach, and you will also be barred from the sporting process. So coming to the next point is one of the commonly observed anti-doping violation possession of prohibited substance or a method kai baar aise hota hai ki hamare athlete jo hote hain bade chalak hote hain and it's worldwide not only in India that they know that this is a banned substance and they know that the implications uske kya honge they know that if the substance is found with them it causes anti-doping rule violation and they may be sanctioned so what they do is they try to pass on these substances to the coach or maybe if some friend some staff working with the team and when they are transiting when they are traveling with the teams and all so they feel that agar aisa kuch kiya mere paas nahi hai kisi aur ke paas hai and then I can take it from them so that will be okay for me okay that's fine with the athlete but it's not always case aisa ho sakta hai ki you may be tested at custom you may be tested at anywhere in your luggage can be tested you may be tested in your games village also if there is a suspicion aur agar aapke paas bhi possession hai to you will also be responsible equally for a violation of anti doping rule and you will be prosecuted and Obviously, investigation में वो पता चल ही जाएगा कि आपके पास किस एथलीट ने पास किया था सो यू नो यू विल बी चार्ज डबली वन फॉर पजेसिंग द बैंड सब्सटेंस सेकेंड फॉर कवरिंग एन एक्ट फॉर बींग सप्रेसिंग एविडेंस एंड यू नो passing taking the possession of the athlete so willingly you knew that athlete was taking the prohibited substance or the method use was done and you did not report to the authority so you will be charged with dual charges so ye aapke liye matlab nobody should be doing that this is against the rule and you should know ki aap kis tarah se phans sakte ho coming to the next thing is administration or attempted administration aap sare log jante hain ki No, we don't encourage that thing. But कुछ चीज ऐसी होती है कि some parents force करते हैं कि नहीं जी हमारे बच्चे का result आना चाहिए और आप अगर ये west में ये लोग ले रहा है अगर बाहर के लोग ये लेते हैं तो हमने भी लेना चाहिए You might come into influence of such parents who are very much concerned about the progress of their children, and अगर आपने ऐसा कुछ इन्फ्लुएंस में आके अगर किसी एथलीट को कोई भी सब्सटेंस दिया या कुछ भी चीज ऐसी दी या खिलाई जो बैन सब्सटेंसेस में आती है वाडा एंटी डोपिंग रूल वायलेशन कर सकती है सो दैट विल बी अगेन यू विल आल्सो बी प्रोसिक्यूटेड बिकॉज यू नोइंगली आपको जानते हुए आपने ये सब किया और किसी के इन्फ्लुएंस में आके किया सो दैट विल नॉट बी एन एक्सक्यूज यू विल बी प्रोसिक्यूटेड इन सच केसेस द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज कम्प्लिसिटी मीनिंग आप किसी भी चीज को करने के लिए सहायता कर रहे हो आपने खुद नहीं किया बट आपने सहायता किया अब आप कैसे कर सकते हो आप डायरेक्टली इन्वॉल्व होके कर सकते हो आप आपको पता है कि ये सब हो रहा है और आप नहीं रिपोर्ट कर रहे हो हायर अथॉरिटीज को दैट इज ऑल्सो काइंड ऑफ अनसेड कंसेंट है कि आपने उसको कंसेंट किया कि आप उसके साथ हो बट यू आर नॉट डाइवर्जिंग द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ अ पर्सन हु इज डूइंग अ क्रिमिनल एक्ट और हु इज डूइंग अ एंटी डोपिंग वायलेशन सो इस कंडीशन को कहते हैं कम्प्लिसिटी एंड आपने अगर ऐसा जस्ट लाइक एन एग्जाम्पल में दिया है कि टीम मैनेजर जो कि आपके एथलीट के बारे में, डोपिंग के बारे में पता था उसको गेम के पहले, और जब टेस्टिंग ऑफिशियल आए तो उसने उसको एविडेंसेस जो थे डोपिंग के, मतलब मे बी सम सिरिंज यूज हुआ हो या कुछ यू नो कंटेंट्स होंगे उसके, रैपर्स होंगा, कुछ भी होगा, सो ही विलफुली सप्रेसेस एंड डिस्पोजेस ऑफ and you know inform the player ki aapka doping ho sakta hai, to try to find a reason that not to give the test, ya bhag jao ya kuch karo. So you know in this case this team manager can be sanctioned because he's complies to this anti-doping rule violation. Now then the other thing is prohibited association. This is the 2.10 of the rule of, you know, definition of anti-doping rule violation, that is prohibited association. एक बहुत ही अहम हिस्सा है और आप सब लोगों को as a coach पता होना चाहिए कि what is a prohibited association. It means कि आप athlete को किसी भी sporting capacity में उसके साथ आप काम नहीं कर सकते या उसको support नहीं कर सकते when he is guilty of doing a anti-doping rule violation, and if he has been convicted, matlab provisional suspension hai ya permanent suspension, in both the cases agar aap usko kisi bhi sporting capacity mein, like sporting capacity meaning as a coach, as his trainer, as his supporter, or as his, you know, you encourage him for doing some training, or you find him another coach who will be taking care of him, that you think that aap nahi kar sakte directly to aap kisi aur ke through karwane ki koshish karoge, so all this is the sporting capacities, or agar in capacities mein aap usko help karne ki koshish karenge, so that will be falling under prohibited association and you will be suspended for the prohibited association. Now let's understand the process of sample collection, ki aapka role as a athlete support personnel sample collection mein kaise hota hai. Basically all the coaches should be aware. Aap hamesha kehte hai ki hamare team ke sath agar koi support staff hai to hum usko bhej denge ye doping process ke liye, but I think, I feel the coach should accompany every time with his athlete to such process of sample, because it is his main responsibility, and that the athlete is safeguarded and athlete exercises his rights and duties while doing the anti-doping process, while completing the process. Hum ek ek cheez janenge detail, matlab not in very great detail, because you all know, aap sab logo ne ye process kai bar dekha hai and bar bar dekha hai, then you might be thinking ki why I am repeating again and again, because इतना देखने के बावजूद हमारे एथलीट्स कई बार मिस्टेक करते हैं ये सब चीजों में, और ये छोटी छोटी जो मिस्टेक्स होती हैं वो आगे बहुत बड़े कॉस्ट कर सकती है. सो इट इज एज अ कोच योर ड्यूटी टू इन्फॉर्म द एथलीट द एग्जैक्ट थिंग. आप उनको उनकी भाषा में समझा सकते हो, यू कैन रिलेट मोर टू देम एंड यू कैन एक्सप्रेस कि क्या उनको यू नो व्हाट प्रिकॉशंस दे हैव टू टेक एंड व्हाट इज योर रोल इन दैट एंटायर प्रोसेस. सो एथलीट सिलेक्शन, जब पहले एथलीट सिलेक्ट होता है, जैसे कि कोई भी रैंडम एलोकेशन उनके पास होता है कि एक लिस्ट आती है, रैंडम लिस्ट होती है, मे बी सम स्पेसिफिक लिस्ट हो सकती है, मे बी वो लॉटरी मेथड से एथलीट सिलेक्ट कर सकते हैं कॉम्पिटिशन में, और उस वजह से वो एथलीट का सिलेक्शन होता है कि सपोज इसका डोप सैंपल लेना है आज. सो दैट विल बी एथलीट सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस. जब एथलीट सिलेक्ट होता है तो उसको नोटिफाई किया जाता है. Now we are looking at two different process. One is in competition testing and one is out of competition testing. जब out competition testing होती है तो एक list आती है head coach के पास में या कि किसी in charge के पास में जहाँ पे वो athlete reside कर रहा है, या तो फिर अगर वो घर पे है तो उसको वहीं पे एक कॉपी जाएगा और एक फेडरेशन के पास कॉपी आएंगी कि आपके एथलीट को टेस्ट करना है और हम उसको टेस्ट करने वाले. सो दैट एथलीट विल बी ड्यूली नोटिफाइड. फिर नोटिफिकेशन में क्या होता है कि आपके जो डोपिंग कंट्रोल ऑफिसर होता है, डीसीओ होता है, वो एथलीट को नोटिफाई करता है कि आपको एंटी डोपिंग प्रोसेस के लिए बुलाया गया है, आपको डोप आपको सैंपल देना है, आपका यूरिन, ब्लड, वट एवर इट इज देयर, सो आपको सैंपल देना होगा. एंड आपके कोच को भी इन्फॉर्म किया जाता है कि ओके आपका इस पर्टिकुलर एथलीट के लिए हम सैंपल कलेक्ट करने वाले हैं. सो दैट विल बी अ नोटिफिकेशन थिंग. वंस दैट इज डन, आप वहाँ पे डेट एंड टाइम्स वो अपने फॉर्म पे लिख लेते हैं, एंड दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज द एंटायर आफ्टर नोटिफिकेशन द एथलीट हैज टू रिपोर्ट बैक विद इन एन आवर टू द एंटी डोपिंग स्टेशन. अगर वो उस चीज में फेल हो जाए, सो इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द एथलीट टू प्रूव हिज इनोसेंस व्हेन द हियरिंग इज डन. I remember one incident जब हम एक बार you know we were at one of the tournament one of the training camp और the anti-doping agencies came by and उन्होंने सुबह सुबह 6:30 बजे खटखटा दिया दरवाजा and they said okay now we have come and this is the notification and the time was 6:30 a.m. so okay so 6:30 a.m. we said कि some athletes are not available because वो लोग शायद running करने गए थे morning में which is a genuine thing वो गए थे and you know being in a foreign country उनका phone नहीं लग रहा था WhatsApp number usually we you know they have this Wi-Fi available but बाहर Wi-Fi नहीं होगा so we waited 1 घंटा हो गया वो athlete आया नहीं so we were worried because the time जैसे जाता है अगर वो उस particular process में नहीं report किया so that will be considered as a anti-doping violation because he refused for I mean he is not present at the sample collection because unhone jo protocol tha the protocol doesn't say that the athlete will be called on his phone the notification is very simple aapne apka jo whereabout diya hai us particular location mein agar aap wahan pe us time mein rehte ho to aapko wo inform karenge agar nahi rehte ho to they will try to contact the first person who is there like suppose if you are staying in a hotel in a आउट इन द टूर्नामेंट तो आपके रिसेप्शन काउंटर पे आपको इंटीमेट किया जाएगा वहां से आपको रूम सर्विस में बेल फोन किया जाएगा इफ यू आर नॉट देयर इन योर रूम दे विल इट इज नॉट द जॉब ऑफ द डीसीओ टू फाइंड आउट वेयर यू आर एंड देन रिपोर्ट यू वो सीधा लिख के जा सकते हैं कि द एथलीट वॉज नॉट फाउंड एट द डिजायर्ड लोकेशन एंड दैट विल बी लाइक अ कंप्लायंस फेलियर द वेयर अबाउट फेलियर सो दैट विल अगेन बी वन ऑफ द वार्निंग फॉर यू योर एथलीट So this is more important that once the athlete is notified, he has to report to the doping station and it is your job as a coach to ensure aapki baaki bahut sari commitments ho sakti hai us duration mein bhi. Suppose wo jeet ke aaya hai and uska sample liya hai, toh uska media interaction ho sakta hai, ye ho sakta hai, wo ho sakta hai. But everything apart, you have to tell him that you go and intimate the doping station. And then take a permission कि आपको ये करना है, cool down करना है, maybe आपको medical attention लेना है, maybe आपको media के पास interview देना है, whatever is there. But this protocol has to be followed. That you have to ask your athlete to report to the anti-doping station immediately after notification. यहाँ पे आपका सबसे important role आता है. Second thing is जब आप report करते हैं doping control station में, उसके बाद आपके साथ एक chaperone लग जाता है. जब से आपको notify किया जाता है, आपके साथ chaperone होता है ताकि आप यू नो आपका एथलीट कहीं कुछ गड़बड़ ना करे उस चीज को देखने के लिए ओवरलुक करने के लिए एंड ऑल सो इन द होल प्रोसेस यू नो ही द शेपरॉन इज विद द एथलीट एंड आपका काम यह है कि आप शांति से उसे कोऑपरेट करेंगे आप उस सिचुएशन में कोई भी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन नहीं क्रिएट करेंगे रादर योर जॉब एज अ कोच वुड बी टू फैसिलिटेट द थिंग्स अगर आपका एथलीट यू नो एंग्शियस है मे बी इज यू नो ही इज नर्वस मे बी अब ऐसा हो सकता है कि योर डोपिंग सैंपल इज टेकन व्हेन द एथलीट हैज लॉस्ट आल्सो बिकॉज़ ही मे बी इन द रैंडम लॉट और मे बी ऐसा तो यू हैव टू कंट्रोल द आस्क योर एथलीट टू कंट्रोल हिज इमोशन एंड यू हैव टू सपोर्ट द एथलीट थ्रू आउट द प्रोसेस देन कम्स द सिलेक्शन ऑफ कंटेंट कलेक्शन वेसल तो एथलीट जब उसको ऑप्शन दिया जाता है कि आप आपके कंटेनर सिलेक्ट करो तो उस रैंडम कलेक्शन सिलेक्शन में आपको आपके एथलीट को ये बताना जरूरी है कि ही हैज टू सिलेक्ट the correct I mean he has to select one of this vessel for collection jisme wo seal hai ya nahi ye pehle dekh le wo tampered hai kahin pe wo dekh le wo ek bar puri tarah se charge kar le dono tino side se dekh ke ki usme jo numbers likhe upar aur niche side mein so that label has to be checked wo sab kuch ek bar apna check kar le and then once he sure wo usko select karke dco ko de ki okay I want to get checked on this collection vessel Once that is done, you will supervise along with your athlete कि वो क्या हो रहा है आगे throughout the process. So आपके athlete को sample देने के लिए बोला जाएगा तो the chaperone will go with the athlete to collect the sample. At this time, you are supposed to be seated in the room where the DCO the process of sample collection was done. जहाँ paperwork हो रहा था आप उस athlete को कुछ नहीं करेंगे आप उस sample को collect करने के लिए DCO को या chaperone को पूरी तरह से आजादी देंगे उस process में you will not obstruct, you will not you know create any obstacle in that. Then comes the जब सैंपल लेके आ जाएगा तो देर विल बी नॉर्मल प्रोसेस कितना वॉल्यूम है वो ए बी सैंपल बॉटल्स में सील होता है आप एक बार चेक कर लेंगे कि सीलिंग प्रॉपर है या नहीं है वो सील हो गए सैंपल्स की वो अपने आप स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी मेजर करते हैं और उसके बाद आपका फॉर्म भरने का प्रोसेस शुरू होता है. नाउ आई वांट कि आप सब कोचेस को ये पता हो कि व्हाट इज एग्जैक्टली द कंटेंट ऑफ द फॉर्म, उसमें क्या चीज इंपॉर्टेंट है. नंबर वन, द टाइम फॉर नोटिफिकेशन जो डाला है वो उस फॉर्म में और आपको जो नोटिफाई किया वो सेम है या नहीं. नंबर टू, आपके जो बॉटल्स जिसमें आपका सैंपल कलेक्ट किया गया था उसका नंबर और फॉर्म के ऊपर डाला हुआ नंबर ये सेम है या नहीं है, और उसके अंदर कोई स्क्रैचेस है या नहीं है फॉर्म पे, बिकॉज इफ देर आर एनी स्क्रैचेस दैट नीड्स टू बी रेक्टिफाइड, काउंटर साइन करना जरूरी होता है. बहुत सी बार ऐसा होता है कि स्क्रैचेस होते हैं, ओवर राइटिंग होता है और वो चीजें नहीं देखी जाती. सो इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द एथलीट एंड द एथलीट सपोर्ट पर्सनल, मीनिंग यू एज अ कोच हु इज सपोर्टिंग द एथलीट देयर थ्रू आउट द प्रोसेस, टू चेक कि ऐसा कुछ है या नहीं है. नंबर थ्री, उस फॉर्म में एक लाइन होती है कि कोच, कोच का नाम क्या. आप सब बोलेंगे कि ये बहुत ही मतलब आसान सवाल है, कोई किसी भी नाम डाल दो, ऐसा नहीं है. द एथलीट हु ट्रस्ट्स वन पर्टिकुलर कोच वो उसका नाम डालेगा. इफ इसका इम्प्लीकेशन आप समझ लीजिए कि अगर आगे इस एथलीट का सैंपल अगर बाई चांस पॉजिटिव आता है या उसको ADRV मतलब एंटी डोपिंग रूल वॉयलेशन में वो प्रोसिक्यूट होता है, तो सबसे पहले जो चेक होता है वो फॉर्म चेक होता है. उस फॉर्म के ऊपर जिस कोच का नाम होगा वो कोच को भी क्वेश्चन किया जा सकता है इस प्रोसेस में. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप ऐसे ही किसी के नाम ना डालो. Once you are accompanying that athlete, you make sure कि वो athlete आप उसको जानते हो ठीक से, and then you once he writes the name, he trusts you, then you know कि उसने कुछ ऐसा किया नहीं है. अगर कुछ किया है तो that has to be brought to the notice of the agencies, you know, any hanky-panky things, any kind of rule violations that has to be brought to notice. Now the second most important thing in that particular form is आपका self declaration जो athlete देता है कि मैंने ये substances last 7 days में लिए हैं. आपको वहाँ पे आपके athlete को confidence में लेके ये समझाना जरूरी होता है कि आपने जो भी लिया है, you please voluntarily declare everything that you have taken. अगर आपने कोई supplement लिया है, आपने कोई tablet लिया है, आपने कोई medicine लिया है, आप उस सब चीजों के नाम आपको जो पता है वो आप वहाँ पे डिक्लेयर करें. बेशक आप 2 pages ले सकते हैं, 3 pages ले सकते हैं, जहाँ जगह कम है तो आप एडिशनल सप्लीमेंट लगा सकते हैं, बट दैट हैज़ टू बी इंश्योर्ड. व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन देयर इज अ एंटी डोपिंग रूल वॉयलेशन, आपको जब नोटिफाई किया जाता है, सपोज कि एक एडवर्स एनालिटिकल फाइंडिंग है, तो सबसे पहले आपका ये फॉर्म चेक किया जाता है कि इस फॉर्म के ऊपर आपने क्या डिक्लेरेशन किया है. अगर इस फॉर्म में आपने लिखा है कि आपने कोई मेडिसिन लिया था या आपने कुछ लिया था, तो ही आपका जो आगे प्लीडिंग मतलब आप जब केस हियरिंग में जाते हैं उस टाइम पे आपको वो इनोसेंस प्रूव करने के लिए चांस दिया जा सकता है कि ओके यू हैड ऑलरेडी मेंशन दैट यू हैड बीन अंडर सम ट्रीटमेंट और यू हैड सम TUE फॉर वन पर्टिकुलर मेडिकल कंडीशन और फॉर मे बी 2 पर्टिकुलर conditions. अगर ऐसा कुछ है, सपोज ऐसा हो सकता है कि आपका एथलीट कोई सब्सटेंस ले रहा हो जो एक डॉक्टर के कंसल्ट से लिया जा रहा है, जिसके लिए उसने TUE अप्लाई किया है, उसके पास एक वैलिड TUE है. तो अगर वैलिड TUE है, अगर वो आपके पास है, तो आपके एथलीट ने वहीं पे फॉर्म में डिक्लेयर करना जरूरी है कि उसके पास TUE है. वो फॉर्म इसे भर के उसको खत्म करने का तरीका नहीं होता है. What happens with our athlete is, okay जी मैंने कुछ नहीं लिया, नहीं मैंने कुछ सब्सटेंस नहीं लिया, मैंने कुछ किया नहीं है, मैं मेरे पास TUE नहीं है, मैं तो किसी चीज से बीमार पड़ा ही नहीं, मैं कभी एडमिट हुआ नहीं, मैंने कुछ लिया ही नहीं, ये सब ऐसा करके what athlete try to do is they skip the time, they try to skip the process. So every step of the process is important. आप उसको समझ के धीरे धीरे you know you should go through each of the steps and ensure कि वो follow हुआ है. ऐसा हो सकता है कि एथलीट आपसे छुपा रहा हो या एथलीट उसको डिक्लेयर नहीं करना चाहता हो, बट आपको पता है कि ये एथलीट के पास ये TUE है या मे बी उसने ये मेडिसिन लिया है. सो यू आस्क द एथलीट टू वॉलंटरी डिक्लेयर. दैट हेल्प्स द यू नो पीपल ऑल्सो टू व्हेन दे डू टेस्टिंग एंड ऑल दिस फॉर्म गोज विद द टेस्टिंग सैंपल के साथ में, और उनको पता चलता है कि ये हम नॉर्मली एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं इस सैंपल में बिकॉज इसने ये टेबलेट ली है और मे बी इसने ये मेडिसिन ली है. सो दैट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट हियर योर रोल एज अ कोच की वॉलंटरी डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ ऑल द सब्सटेंसेस दैट एथलीट हैज कंज्यूम्ड विद इन लास्ट 7 days. और मे बी अगर लास्ट 7 days में नहीं किया है, मे बी लास्ट 15 days में किया है, सो यू कैन ऑलवेज टेल द DCO दैट ओके मैंने ये लास्ट 7 days में नहीं किया है बट इसके पहले वाले वीक में किया है. सो दैट हैज टू बी इंश्योर्ड दैट दिस एंटायर थिंग इज डन. इसके बाद जब आता है कि लैबोरेटरी में वो सैंपल प्रोसेस होते हैं, आपको आपके सैंपल एनालाइज होते हैं, अगर नेगेटिव है तो आपको कुछ नहीं बताया जाएगा, बट अगर पॉजिटिव रहा आपका ये सैंपल तो आपके फेडरेशन को इन्फॉर्म किया जाएगा, वहां से आपको इंटीमेट किया जाएगा, एंड देन यू नो आपको मतलब आपके एथलीट को इंटीमेट किया जाएगा, एंड ऑब्वियसली इफ the athlete is intimated, you will also be intimated subsequently because you being the coach or the athlete support personnel with that particular athlete. Now what happens? What are the implications? Jab aapko intimate kiya gaya hai ki aapka sample positive hai, to athlete has a choice whether to accept the thing or challenge the adverse analytical finding. Hum isse bolte hai positive aana matlab adverse analytical finding aayi hai. Wo, it doesn't mean that wo athlete ne dope kiya hai. उस एडवर्स एनालिटिकल फाइंडिंग को वो चैलेंज कर सकता है, एंड वंस ही चैलेंजेस देयर इज अ आगे का प्रोसेस इन्वॉल्वड वेयर दैट सैंपल विल बी अगेन रीटेस्टेड, आई मीन द बी सैंपल विल बी टेस्टेड जो कि आपके कलेक्शन के टाइम पे स्टोर किया गया था सेफली. सो अगर वो बी सैंपल टेस्ट करके उसके रिजल्ट आते हैं, नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, देयर आर टू पॉसिबिलिटीज, या तो वो नेगेटिव आएगा तो फिर कुछ होना ही नहीं है, द प्रोसेस विल बी अबॉर्टेड और जो प्रोविजनल इनएलिजिबिलिटी थी वो खत्म हो जाएगी. बट अगर वो पॉजिटिव आता है देन यू विल गो फॉर अ हियरिंग और अ ट्रायल दैट विल बी अगेन इन द कोर्ट ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन, और जो उस कंट्री का डिसिप्लिनरी पैनल होगा उसके आगे वो आपका हियरिंग होगा उस पर्टिकुलर एंटी डोपिंग एजेंसी के लिए. अगर आप किसी गेम्स में इन्वॉल्व हुए हैं तो उस गेम्स को ने जिसको जिस लेबोरेटरी को जिस एंटी डोपिंग एजेंसी को इन्वॉल्व किया था उसके डिसिप्लिनरी पैनल के सामने आपको जाना पड़ेगा, एंड द हाईएस्ट अपीलेट पैनल इज यू नो द कोर्ट ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन. It is different, you know, you will have to go, that is the highest appellate authority. So what happens, your role as a athlete support personnel during the process. Now what article 2.10 says is you are supposed not to be there with the person who is serving the ban or who has been under provisional suspension or maybe jisne anti-doping rule violation kiya hai, so that comes under prohibited association. So as soon as the athlete is notified and he is provisionally suspended and that you come to know, your first thing should be to intimate the authorities, all the concerned authorities which are you know taking care of this athlete. Maybe agar aap नेशनल कैंप में है तो आप सबसे पहले आपके सेंटर इंचार्ज को बताएंगे, आपके फेडरेशन को इन्फॉर्म करेंगे. अगर आप किसी पर्टिकुलर सर्विसेज में हैं, लाइक सपोज इफ यू आर इन आर्मी देन यू विल इन्फॉर्म योर कमांडिंग ऑफिसर अबाउट इट, एंड ऑब्वियसली द कंसर्न फेडरेशन विल ऑल्सो बी इन्फॉर्म्ड अबाउट दैट थिंग. अगर आप किसी स्कूल में हैं या यूनिवर्सिटी में हैं तो आप उस पर्टिकुलर यूनिवर्सिटी के यू नो जो who looks after the sports, that is the sports officer honga, usko batayenge and the higher authorities involved, and obviously the aapka jo line of ye pehle se decide honga us particular university ka protocol honga wo aap follow karenge. So notification has to be done. Second thing is the athlete has to be advised to pack up his belongings and go home. He cannot stay in our training facility because there will be a prohibited association, and in that clause you cannot risk other athletes or you know you cannot risk yourself also being associated in the sporting capacity with that athlete. So that is one of the important thing that ye aapko pata hona chahiye ki prohibited association kya hota hai. Now as the investigation goes on aur agar usne hearing panel ke samne gaya aur usko uski matlab uska innocence prove hua ya usko kuch ban laga, maybe the let's say ki uska he is not found guilty but they have decreased his ban from 4 years to maybe say 1 year, 1 year ineligibility. So now your job as a coach will be not to engage with that athlete in a capacity, in a coaching capacity. Aap uske coaching nahi karenge ya usko koi bhi support nahi karenge with for that 1 year ineligibility period. Agar aap इसको सपोर्ट करते हैं या इसको कोचिंग करते हैं बाय एनी मींस, एंड इफ समबडी कंप्लेन्स अगेंस्ट यू या इफ इट इज ब्रॉट टू अवर नोटिस बाय द एजेंसीज, इफ इट इज ब्रॉट टू नोटिस, देन आपको भी हियरिंग के लिए बुलाया जा सकता है, आप पे कार्रवाई हो सकती है, आपके डिपार्टमेंट को इंटीमेट किया जाएगा कि यू कमिटेड यू नो एंटी डोपिंग रूल वायोलेशन ऑफ प्रोहिबिटेड एसोसिएशन, एंड योर दैट मे बी द एंड ऑफ योर करियर. बिकॉज एथलीट के लिए तो 3-4 साल का बैन लगा हो सकता है, मे बी 1 year का होगा, मे बी 2 साल का होगा, मे बी 4 साल का होगा, बट शायद आपके लिए वो परमानेंट बैन हो सकता है, एंड दैट मे बी द एंड ऑफ योर स्पोर्टिंग करियर. सो प्लीज टेक इट सीरियसली, इट इज नॉट अ मैटर ऑफ यू नो हंसी मजाक में लेने की बात नहीं है एंड यू शुड पे अटेंशन अबाउट दिस प्रोहिबिटेड एसोसिएशन. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इन इंडिया सिंस पीपल आर इग्नोरेंट अबाउट लॉज एंड रूल्स पीपल से दैट मुझे पता नहीं था. यू कैन नॉट से मुझे पता नहीं था बिकॉज ये सब चीजें आपको बार बार बताई जा रही है एंड एज अ पर्सन हु वर्क्स इन द स्पोर्ट्स यू शुड बी थरो विद द ऑल 10 एंटी डोपिंग रूल वायोलेशंस एंड आपका रोल क्या है एंड वंस इफ by mistake also you have committed it, it there is no going back from it. You cannot say that you don't know. It is presumed, it is assumed that you all know about this thing and you willfully try to, you know, ignore things and commit the rule violation. So I'll again and again I'm insisting because many of you may not be knowing about the seriousness of this issue, about the prohibited association and its implication in the coaching field. So what happens, ab aap kahoge ki when this athlete is serving ban, then what he can do? Well, he can do his own training, but he will not use any of the facility of the government or any of the facility of the organization which he was working with or he was supported by or sponsored by, because he is banned from doing that. What can happen is he can come back to the training facility 2 months before the ban finishes. Like suppose agar uske upar ek saal ka ban laga hai to 10 mahine ke baad mein wo ek apply kar sakta hai ki mujhe training ki ijazat di jaye, mera ban is tarikh ko khatam ho raha hai aur ab usko 2 mahine hai. So that 2 period grace period is allowed by WADA. So as per the rule 2 mahine pehle wo aa sakta hai ya last term mein wo apply kar sakta hai of the ban. That is one of the provision that is given at present in the law, rule. So, you know, in the end, if I want to summarize, these are the qualities that a coach should have. I'm not going into detail because this you all know ki achhe coach ko kya hona chahiye. But, you know, as a support person, you should have an additional quality of about understanding the WADA code and, you know, implement it in your day-to-day practice. What you should do, I have just summarized on this slide about the entire thing, about entire message that I wanted to convey, ki the roles and responsibility of athlete support personnel. Ki aap ek achha coaching environment banayenge jisme aap, you know, personal excellence jo hai, matlab, it should not be that by hook or by crook. You should give time for natural development of that athlete. And his overall excellence should be nurtured. Not only that, you know, by hook or crook, I have to win. I have to make this athlete win because I have to prove something. It's not about you proving something. The athlete, if he is good and if your coaching is good, he will definitely shine. Maybe not now, but maybe later on. So that's the thing. That, and you know, growing environment should be there. A positive environment should be there. You should not have any negative things. You should not have any, you know, ill activities going on, or you should not encourage such activities that cause anti-doping rule violations when you're working with the athletes. You should not encourage them. I mean, you should always be educating about the athletes that what they should eat, how they should be behaving, how they should be keeping themselves, you know, in the training camp. What are the banned substances? What are their effects? You should explain them. There are many coaching programs available and you can get literature about them. You can explain in simple words to your athletes the consequences of, you know, violations and their implications on the athlete's career, because 4 saal ke liye ban hona is just like throwing out of the competition cycle. It's difficult to come back, and believe me, those who have served the ban and come back, such athletes are very rare and they are very dedicated people, because it takes great challenge to serve the ban, come back from the ban, and then come back in the performance. It's not everybody's cup of tea. It's I would say very, very, very few athletes would be able to do that. And why to spare the horror of, you know, athletes going to such things when you can simply educate them and prevent these things? There are obviously other apps available, Global DRO, that you can check the contents of the medicines and supplements, if they are in banned substance or not, to keep you informed. You can always take a help of anti-doping agency or the medical staff attached with the CAMS, or maybe, you know, at your place who have some knowledge about this anti-doping thing, and update yourself from time to time. There is one program on WADA e-learning platform that is True Coach. I urge you all to go through this program, complete the program and complete your e-learning and download your certificate of completion. It will give you a lot of knowledge about the anti-doping process and your role as a coach, and it will clear most of your doubts that you have or may be having, and thus you can update yourself. So the information is updated every year in this e-learning platform, and it's a wonderful program that I feel every coach should be undertaking for his knowledge update. And lastly, you have to integrate the spirit. You have to maintain the spirit of sports, that is fair play. And you should always encourage that fair play and help the anti-doping agencies to curb the menace of doping. So that was all regarding the, you know, the last slide speaks everything. Your athletes look up to you. So if you are a role model and you are a strict person who follows rules and regulations, your athlete will imitate you. They will be like you. But if you are not up to mark, then they will not see you as an ideal and they might go into wrong direction. So the first thing is you have to be up to mark, and then only you can create a good impression on the athlete's mind. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor. Any questions you put in the group chat, as usual? This is a very important topic. Doctor, you mentioned one site where they can do some questionnaire.
Yeah, that's WADA's e-learning platform, yes. ADEL.
Can you Anti-doping.
I will just show in the slide.
Because instead of people having to search for it, if we can give it to them, it will be easier.
Yeah, Coach True. Yeah, so this is the program. From here, you can go to site and you can actually take the program. It's a very step-by-step information, and there are various modules of this program. So what happens is you can get full information right from the anti-doping list to whereabouts and how to file the whereabouts and how to complete the anti-doping process for your athletes and what is your role, everything as a coach. And it gives every information that you are supposed to know as a coach. And then at the end of the program, you get a certificate of completion. So I think you can actually download that certificate and keep it to you that you have completed this program. Now, I think, Coach, we can take the questions, I think. So I see there is one question. It's from Richa. What is particular time duration for approaching after getting notification, as you told athlete knows or no? See, important is in the competition and out of competition, there are two different things about notification. In the competition, once you are notified, there is always a chaperone running with you. So they will not let you to go anywhere. So that way you will always have to report the doping station, the anti-doping station. But what happens in out of competition, when the DCO comes and he tries to intimate or, you know, inform, then suppose let's take example that we are in a national coaching camp and the WADA people or maybe NADA people, they come and they respond and they come to the hostel. So let's say suppose you have given, your athlete has given that the timing for his whereabout is 6:30 to 7:30. They come around 6:45 and they report to the hostel. Now what they will do, they will not go to your room. They will just intimate the person in the hostel reception that, okay, we want to test this athlete, and it is you just inform him that we are here, we want to speak to them. Now the person will go to the room, tell, come back. This will take some time. Obviously there will be some time involved. In that time, if the person is not there in the room, then they will do the next procedure. They will ask the person who is in charge of that center. They will intimate him that, okay, we are here for testing and we want to test this particular person. Kindly ask him to come and report us within that particular time. They will give a deadline. It's mostly an hour. And then the center in charge will ring, you know, he will pull his strings. Maybe he'll intimate the athlete. But what happens in the process? If suppose athlete is not there and on paper, his whereabout is that he is present at the hostel and he's not there at that moment. And it takes more than an hour for him to come back. The DCO will not wait. He will wait simply for that particular deadline, which he is supposed to wait. That is an hour from the intimation or notification. And after that, he can go home saying that the athlete was not available for testing or athlete was absconded, and that there is no thing or there is nothing you can do or you can challenge in that cases. Because what they do is interesting thing, even I was not knowing, and in a few years back we had one such incident, and then I was like, we didn't see you because you didn't notify us. And then I got an email from the anti-doping agency that we had intimated at this time the photo of the watch and the guard who was there at that time in the boxing hall. And with that, there was a statement from the guard that this particular athlete was involved at that particular 7:15 time. That was a time, Sunday morning, I remember, in that investigation. Then there was a photograph of the hostel register in and out where we keep the athlete is present or not present. And there the athlete was not on the out thing, like he was not going out. So they had all these records. So once you see that, when they come, they take all these records into consideration, and only then they may leave and your athlete. So it's the anti-doping agency has its own rules. They follow the protocol, and it is your duty that as soon as you are notified, you just run and get and inform the DCO that, okay, I'm present here and I want to give the sample. I'm not in any way running away and I just need some time to settle. Maybe you can give him reason, and if the reason is justifiable, if it is humanly justifiable, they will obviously consider that. So I think I have answered your query about this thing. Any more questions from? Coach, I don't see any questions.
Yeah, I don't see any questions either.
It means that either I was very boring in the lecture or everybody has.
Here is a question. What Pushkar Raj Pant, what are the responsibility of athlete after he's found positive in test? Can coach support him morally? Or what will be responsibility of coach?
See, it's a very tricky situation. And ideally, I would say that you should not intimate the athlete orally. When the what happens is when the athlete is notified about the anti-doping rule violation, that is ADR, presence of adverse analytical finding, it is usually through the federation, through one of the letter, and the federation issues him the notice. Or if he is directly involved, maybe he is not a camp athlete, or maybe he is a university athlete, then he is intimated on his address of communication that he had intimated in the form, which was filled in the. That's why I was telling the importance of that form is that whatever you put on that form is more important. The address, the numbers, the email, everything, because that is the thing which will be going through the entire process. And it might happen that you give wrong information and you may not be, they may intimate you and you may never know about it. So on that address, they will intimate. And obviously you will, if you come to know, you may intimate your department in a manner that you can, like suppose if you're a Sai coach and it happens in your Sai trainee, then obviously you have to give in written to your center head that, okay, such a such thing happened in the so-and-so Sai trainee and so-and-so thing has been served to him, that is brought to my notice on date so-and-so, on time so-and-so, and I have, please guide me what is to be done next. You do not take any chances about doing anything. I mean, as a coach, you cannot tell him that you go pack your bags and go. But yeah, obviously you can guide him unofficially off the records, but officially you cannot tell him that you go, because you know that can go against you also, because he might pull some fake charges against you, might be call you that you are accomplice to his acts and all. So in order to avoid that, please follow the institutional protocol, and those are different for different institutions. The standard way would be to intimate your superior, the center head, and ask him for the further directions.
I would say this: we need to take these things very seriously. You know, 50% of the positive doping cases are by mistake doping. People who don't know, I took this, I got this from my cousin, I got this my neighbor, I got this from my grandmother. They don't know what they're taking, and they take chances, and they think that they are innocent. So these, the only two things to fight against doping is constant testing, which fortunately is in our camps, it's and at the international arena, we have quite many testing. And the second thing is constant education. We need to talk about this. If we never talk about doping, then people will start trying to find the easy way. And it is not fair to, if one is doping and all the others who are in the same camp are innocent, this should not touch on the rest. But we need to make it, make sure that we have an even playing field. And we see many of the top athletes, boxers and others, international, they are getting caught. So that means that at a certain point, the testing is working. It is working. People are getting suspended from different countries. So that means that, okay, then WADA is trying to keep up the system, and it's good for us. Gupta?
The bottom line I would say is zero tolerance for doping, and you as a coach should not be tolerating any of these things. If it is brought to your notice, you should always report to the superiors.
Hi, Doctor. Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
So I fully agree, and I think everybody should agree that there should be a 0%.
Sir, agree is different. Everybody knows it.
Yeah, I am coming to the next point only. Everybody agrees. What happens, you know, the doctor guides. You have given the responsibility to all the coaches. Now it becomes their responsibility. How much they own, it differs. And sometimes if they wanted to own it, which is sentence you have used lastly, that yaar uske bete ki performance aayi, hamare bete ki nahi aayi.
That happens.
No, we know everyone. And secondly, sometimes the sportsman is also not satisfied. If as a coach you are controlling him, he will not try to train under yourself, because in this age everybody is competing against the best ones, maybe eligible or not that one. So they will leave you as a coach. Coach also have a little fear about that one, that I was trying from last so many years. But the one aspect is clear, that if in this era of sports you will take something, you cannot be escape free. You will be caught. And definitely it is just like a cancer. It will get you a bad name, the federation, country, and it all has negative effect, nothing positive. You will ruin the nation, and you will be a black spot. So
5 years back, there was no role of athlete support personnel being caught. Yesterday, I was reading on WADA's website. They have published a list of around 100 or 200 athlete support personnel who are suspended for being accomplice or, you know, involving anti-doping rule violation. The athlete support personnel, the coaches, their names are given as per country. The list is given on WADA website. So, you know, 100 is a significant number worldwide who are suspended, who are caught. There are thousands who are not caught. So this is
I cannot talk this thing here on the camera. But we know that when we are going to the company, there may be some lapses are always there.
No, we should learn from this. That's the only bottom line I want to say.
Lapses. Because start committing all those while looking at others, then we will also be guilty ones. So
yes,
ultimately,
yes.
I will say we as a team, the doctor is advising the coaches, and he is giving his responsibilities to share with the coaches. Now coaches become the more responsible. Now that responsibility has to be shared between sportsperson, coach, doctor, and the person, those who are having an influence on that athlete. Sometimes definitely, all the three persons are there. They are very good.
Obviously.
But the third picture is there, which is having more impact. That also has to be convinced. He can be anyone. I cannot name. So that if we want to go clear cut best on this track. We all as a team has to work together, and if something comes to notice in anyone, they must share with each other so that how it can be controlled.
Definitely.
With these words, I congratulate you. It is a very good lecture. I think more benefit I have given in the comment also that coaches ko aapne bata diya, bhai, aapki kya kya responsibilities hai, kya kya duties hai. Aake dekho aapne kya karna hai. Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank
you. Okay. I thank everybody, and we'll see you tomorrow, same time. And we have two more lectures. Tomorrow we have the psychologist, and on Wednesday we'll do a round panel and sum up all this online program. Thank you to all. Good evening.